actually had a one-day break, no? After they finished up their duties in the FIBA Asia Cup 2021 qualifiers, Coach Tab Baldwin gave them the Monday off to just heal up and rest and enjoy each other's company and maybe stay a little bit later on that Sunday after the second win against Korea. But after that, back to work na kanina, no? They practice at 10 a.m., practice from 10 to 12. So they just work on the same stuff. They honed their offense. They took care of their defense. They ran a couple of things that, you know, they could use against China in their tune-up game at 4:30 tomorrow. And again, the entire theme of Coach Tab Baldwin with this squad is teaching. And that's what they continue to do earlier. It's them just focusing on the stuff that they were doing from way back in Laguna, trying to remember it, trying to refresh it once again, trying to perfect it. That has been part of the process. And they're not stopping. Every time that they get to practice, they go back to that.
Okay, well, back to work, back to teaching, like you mentioned. This tune-up game that you mentioned tomorrow against China, maybe you can give us an insight on how this actually came to be.
Actually, it was China who really planned to stay here at the Quest Hotel for an extended period of time. They wanted to travel from here directly to Canada. So when the Philippines figured that this was a possibility for them, and then they started talking. I think it was a back and forth between our federation, the Samahang Basketball ng Pilipinas, and China's federation. They started talking, of course, coordinating with FIBA as well. And then it all just came together. They saw that it would be mutually beneficial for both teams to go play a tune-up match against each other. Because, you know, every game that you play is a step towards the right direction. It could prepare you for the future games ahead. China is going to Canada to face really good teams there as well. Canada and Greece, I believe. And then we will be facing really talented teams in Serbia and the Dominican Republic. So we're up against giants. And every little bit of additional preparation would help us in those games. They are not going into this game, you know, doing film on China with the sole focus of beating China. It's not for that, diba? Parang yun yung inaakala natin. Since they're practicing for China and doing film on China, maybe they're really preparing to beat China at all costs. It's not that. It's actually more to develop a rhythm, to develop something that you could carry forward. Diba? It's a process. When you go up against a team, you practice your stuff, you try to study them, you present it to the players for them to see where they could attack, what could work. Because if everyone is thinking about you know, that matchup, then it will be better for the team. So this is to develop the team for the long run. Mm-hmm. Because they will have to do this over and over again, starting with Serbia and the Dominican Republic, and then moving forward for August for the FIBA Asia Cup. They will have to do this multiple times in a span of 2 weeks. So if you get into that flow, into that normal routine of really dissecting the opponents, yung mga makakalaban mo, nakikilala mo sila, you get to work as a team, share ideas with your coaches. It's all part of the process. So huwag kayong magugulat that they're studying this hard for a tune-up game, because this will teach itong Gilas Pilipinas to really focus on doing this for the long run.